Give her a big hand. Come on. So now we get to the purpose of me standing up here before you today, all right? And I'm here to explain the nomination process and introduce the team of phenomenal people who made the selections, okay? St. Paul is not entering the 150 years in isolation.
Amen.
It's not a solo act, okay? We are celebrating people who have made a tremendous impact on the community. Back in February of this year, the team of people I'm about to introduce started receiving nominations from people throughout the community who they felt made a tremendous impact to St. Augustine. Nominations notices were sent to local churches, schools, businesses, and various facets of the community. The nomination committee received over 60 nominations from various community members and reviewed all of them to determine the top three in each category. The nomination committee includes five phenomenal leaders in their own right. So I'm going to announce these five. Hold your applause, okay? So we're going to start with Regina Gale Phillips, Executive Director of Lincolnville Museum. Please stand. Cynthia A. Williams, Senior Director for the Innovation and Equity for the St. John's County School District.
Yes, Cynthia.
She has previously been named St. John's County Teacher of the Year. Check this out.
Where is she?
She was also named Principal of the Year. Huh? Please stand. She's not here. Okay.
I don't see Cynthia.
Next we have Thomas Jackson, Chair of Dr. Martin Luther King Annual Commemorative Breakfast Committee, board member for Fort Mosaic, and instrumental in the current preservation efforts for the Butler House on Butler Beach. Okay? Last but surely not least, Jorge Rivera, community advocate, local media giant, and TV host, member of the Cultural Council, and producer of wonderful Puerto Rican jazz events. Okay, I know y'all anxious for it. Y'all ready to start clapping. All right, please give them a big round of applause. So now I know you all been waiting to hear the words from our great pastor and leader, Dr. Alicia Ford Burst, will present the awards. Thank you, and please continue to enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Good evening.
Amen.
Everybody feeling okay right now?
Amen.
Is everyone full?
Yes.
Is the food good?
Yes.
Great day.
It is a great day.
So we some of the people who and are listed on your program, because as Brother Dillon mentioned, St. Paul is not in existence for 150 years because of being in isolation, but because of many people in the community who have also supported the church. The first person that I would like to recognize, and this is a surprise, but she has been around for 100 years, but she is also one of the most energetic people in the church.
Amen.
At 100 years old, she will work in the kitchen from Jesus. 6 a.m. to 9 o'clock p.m.
Yes, Jesus.
So let's give that a great round of applause.
Yes, Jesus.
Yeah.
I would like Brother Burns to come in and sit with me as we give out the awards tonight.
I say yes, Lord.
So we will see who they are, Michelle Cooley and Vicki Elmore. played a pivotal role in the civil rights movement of 1964. The Accord, under Ms. Duncan's supervision, housed, displayed articles, stories, artifacts that are set up to tell the stories of the civil rights movement of St. Augustine. She brings to light the rich history of the 1960 movement led by Dr. Robert Haley, Dr. Martin Luther King, and the Southern Christian Leadership Conference. Her services range from a tax assistant volunteer for the Community Action Agency and a fundraiser for St. Augustine. Former Mayor Tracy Upchurch. Tracy Upchurch, as mayor of St. Augustine, worked to bring the community together. And he tried to do what was best for all of the citizens of St. Augustine. He received his Juris Doctor degree from the University of Florida in 1981, an MA degree in American history, serves as an associate professor of law and history, as well as a chair of the pre-law program at Flagler College. His research focuses on American Civil War, and the particular Southern Unionists in Florida. As mayor, he was monumental in the removal of the Confederate monuments. He is a cultural and heritage-focused elected mayor of St. Augustine in 1990 to 1992. Our last person in this category is Gregory B. White. He advocated for the underserved communities in St. John's County for over 30 years. His contributions have led to the community of West Augustine to many accomplishments that have made the area a remarkable value in Florida. He is the founder of the Kids Safe Zone, past commander of the American Legion Post 194, past chairman for the West Augustine CRA Steering Committee, president of the West Augustine Historical CDC, and Chase Ricola Scholarship Chairperson. He lobbied for jobs for the residents in the community, for affordable housing for residents of West Augustine. And in this category, after much deliberation, the community decided that this award should go to Brother Greg White.
Yay!
Go Army! Go Army! Go Army!
Systems, a premier provider of military aircraft, and he has made a tremendous impact in the community as a site produces, modifies, repairs, and overhauls military aircrafts. Bradley has served as the operations deputy. In his role, Bradley leads personnel supporting company-wide operational efforts. Also in this category is Arnett Chase. He has been a pillar in the St. Augustine, St. John's community for several years. He followed the family business of Leo C. Chase and Son Funeral Home in 1977 after his father passed, now named Chase & Associates, and under the direction of his children, he remains the oldest Black-owned business in the county, having operated since 1955. He was also one of the first elected African-American in politics in St. John's County and St. Augustine. Next we have Charles Sampson. He organized the Sampson Drywall, one of the longest running African-American businesses in St. Augustine. He started the business in 1984 and has continuously operated this business in the community. Over the years, Sampson has provided employment for many individuals living in the community. He is also a great supporter of causes and organizations that benefit from his business. In this category, the committee has selected Arnett Chase as a...
Yeah, yeah.
His gifts was God's glory in St. Augustine. He worked with the Presbyterian disaster to help secure relief funds for those affected by Hurricane Matthew and Irma. He leads Memorial Presbyterian with compassion, wisdom, and imagination. He is 22 years ordained in ministry, 12 years at Memorial Presbyterian, 5 years at Head of Staff. Dr. Camp has written numerous articles for the St. Augustine Record on faith and civility. He is active in the Rotary Club downtown, clergy, MLK breakfast, prayer breakfast, past president and founder of the St. Augustine Interfaith Community, prays for city council meetings of St. Augustine. First people that embraced me when I came here, and he's a phenomenal person. He has published work interviewed by the National Church for being a leader who grows churches. Next in this category, we have Pastor David Williamson. He is the current pastor of Grace United Methodist Church. Pastor Williamson is actively involved in the community for numerous years. He has been in the ministry for over 21 years, preaching and teaching 2 to 3 times a week. He has been an active unifier in the community. He brings people together from all walks of life. He supports homeless families and has been an advocate for civil rights and made a positive impact in St. Augustine. He is ordained minister in the United Methodist Church. He recently completed the Boston Marathon back in 2018. After donating a kidney to his sister, he completed running the Boston Marathon 5 months after the surgery.
Amen.
In this category, we also have Reverend Pastor Laverne Marsh, who isn't here. So in this category, the winner is Pastor David Williams.
Hear, hear!
April 20th, 2024. Ashley Chapman currently leads the Black Student Union at Blackwood College and serves as a Lincolnville Museum intern. She is a tutor at Reset St. Augustine, a vocal advocate within her community, and an intern for AASA, the School Superintendents Association Award. She is a thinker and a leader's scholar. She's the recipient of the IRTS Multicultural Career Workshop, and she's a member of the NAACP. She's a regional gold medalist and scholastic art and writing medalist.
She got everything.
Tyler Holmes is a popular student at Murray Middle School and a member of the Boys and Girls Club for the past 8 years. He is a captain of the golf team at TPC. He's also a volunteer. Tyler is the 2023 winner of the highest awards you can achieve in the Boys and Girls Club. He is a youth of the year of middle school and competed against hundreds of other members. The winner of this category is Ashley Chapman.
They're here! Go Ash! Go Ash!
JV football coach and has the JV football team and assistant varsity coach at St. Augustine High School athletic director to present. He's the co-founder of the Reset program. On 2005, he was on the 2005 state championship team at St. Augustine High, a graduate of Western Kentucky. Was the 2017 St. John's County Coach of the Year, received the 2021 St. John's Youth Service Award. Principal Bethany Groves has demonstrated commitment by working at Webster for the last 8 years. She has a history of working in education management. She has worked with struggling schools to overcome social injustice of poverty and inequity. Principal Groves has a heart for children and is doing a great job at Webster Elementary. She believes in supporting underprivileged children. She works hard to get the resources for after school programs and other school programs.
I have to go meet her.
LaChance Stevens.
Oh, Chance.
She is an author and storyteller for performance and performing arts. Over the last 30 years, she has trained over 500 St. John's County youth in dance, cheer, and the performing arts.
LaChance
wants to change the youth's vision to become bigger than their generational expectations in life and performing arts. She has created a youth model that has sent many youngsters to secondary education, college, and professional. She has received numerous community awards. She is the first African American cheer coach in St. John's County and director of cheer and dance at St. Augustine High. Ms. Stevens is a teacher at the Barbizon Model and Acting School and worked with St. John's Casablanca Modeling and Career Services. She is the founder of the Golden Flames Dance Team. Cheer director for West Augustine Athletic Association. She has been invited to perform at the Miami Dolphins halftime show, and she's a three-time Macy's Parade. You've recognized three times in the Macy's Parade youth event. She is a designer of kids' uniforms and a dance gear creator and choreographer. Let's give all three of these people a
break. We're here.
Go band. Go band.
Now, she
Listen, she is not alone. There's a lady around here with a black dress and pearls walking around with a clipboard telling everybody what.
Lauren. Lauren. CIA.
CIA. She's probably out there in Boston somewhere.
There was a CIA. Yes, she is.
If anybody wants a master sergeant, director, every I dotted, every T crossed,
Central Intelligence Division,
call you in the morning, late night, don't matter, text message 6 a.m., 5 a.m., email 2 a.m. But the experience that we are having tonight is largely a result of the work of these two ladies. And I am so happy and pleased to be able to work with Lauren Darton. Please come
here. Yeah, yeah.
Lincolnville Museum and Cultural Center, and the Romanza Festival of of music and the arts. Let's give them all a big round.
We're here.
Winston Burr.
show him some love. Consultant. We are grateful for this opportunity, and we are grateful that we were able to celebrate this 150th church anniversary with all of you. I want to share that we have a goal of raising $150,000 for our 150 years of operation. And I thought it was a very easy task initially. It hasn't been as easy as I thought. But
she
knows really well.
She's at home.
And we figured $1,000 per year that the church has been existing. Easy, right? Well, we're getting there. Today, I am pleased and happy to announce that we have been able to raise supporting young people, because we don't want any of our young people to go in the wrong direction. So we want to be that place that they can go and feel comfortable and safe and learn and grow, not just spiritually, but grow intellectually, grow socially, and understand the right things to do. We are their role models. And I can go on about young people, because I know in my own life it was the Boys and Girls Club, the YMCA, Upward Bound, all those programs that helped me become who I am today. A little girl growing up in the project.
Amen.
Have been able to achieve a great number of things because of the support that other people expressed and poured into me. So all of you have a little envelope on your table. If you feel led, fill it out. Jasmine is in the back, and we will, as you exit, and you just drop the envelope in that box. Not only are we raising funds for our young people, but at the other end of the spectrum, we're generating funds for our senior citizens. All of us will get old one day, and all of us will need help and assistance. And I have had the opportunity to see the needs of several senior citizens in the Lincolnville and in the St. Augustine community. A lot of them have old houses. A lot of them need food and clothing and things of that nature. So we want to generate revenue specifically for our senior citizen ministry to help with home repairs and items such as that, as well as our young people. So having said that, please support us. And if you have made a bid, we have asked the souvenir of the auction team to send you a text message. You can look at your phones before you leave, and if you receive the message that says, congratulations, you won, please go out. Somebody won? Oh, you won? Somebody want a big basket of bourbon, and I was like,
that's the challenge.
A big basket of liquor.
Did you get that?
Just don't do it when you come to the church. I mean, just now on Sunday, okay, all right.
I made big money. I could have made some big money.
So please check your phones. All the items will be on the other side of this wall. Thank you so much. And now I ask Pastor David Williamson to come and do the closing prayer. All hearts are good. All hearts are clear. Yes. Let's just give God some praise.
Celebration of 150 years of community transforming ministry for St. Paul African Methodist Episcopal Church. Through the riches of your glory, dear Lord, you have given strength to the inner being of the people of St. Paul with power through your Spirit. For 150 years, for nearly four generations, you have dwelt in their hearts through faith. You have sustained them with your great love, and by your great power at work in them, you have accomplished abundantly far more than all they could ask or imagine. And in the midst of harmful, terrorizing, difficult days of oppression, you have breathed peace and power and joy into them. And so that through them, you have shown St. Augustine, St. John's County, the nation, and the world that there is a better way to live. Through the people of St. Paul, we pray you continue to reveal your power to heal the sick, to feed the hungry, to reconcile sinners, to raise up children in the way that they should go, to resist racism, sexism, oppression in whatever forms they present themselves. Through the people of St. Paul, continue to proclaim the good news of your abundance in the face of scarcity, cooperation in the midst of competition culture, and love, which is the only power great enough to transform enemies into friends. So here tonight, as the people of St. Paul have lifted and appreciated people who have made a difference throughout our community, they have shown us once again the power of self-giving love, building others up, reflecting the life of Jesus in the way that they live. For such a life-giving and community-transforming witness, we give you all glory, honor, and praise. And now to him who by the power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than all we could ask or imagine. To him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Amen.
Can you all
have a seat
briefly, because I wanted to allow Sister Tyson to get out to the front of the door so that she'll be able to greet everyone going out, please, just real quickly, Sister Tyson, and we'll process out and meet everyone.
Thank you.
my brother, my brother.
Kenny told me to grab all this, but I'm trying.
I got this.